At Embedded World 2024, I showed you some products that Raspberry Pi had brought along to tease us with, but did not officially announce, including their Raspberry Pi camera. Well, now it has been officially released, and I have one to unbox and take a look at. So let's take a look at what's in the box. First, let's get this anti-static bag out and take out the camera module itself and two ribbon cables. Why two? Well, if you look here at the difference between the camera connector on the Raspberry Pi 4 and the camera slash display connectors on the Raspberry Pi 5, the 5 has a more compact connector, so you'll have to use the appropriate cable for that. Like most of the other Raspberry Pi cameras, the AI camera is not autofocus, but one really cool accessory that it comes with is a focus ring. I have so many other Raspberry Pi cameras and focus was always difficult, either turning it with my fingers when possible, but sometimes it was too tight so I used pliers. It was always a mess. Now we get this handy tool for adjusting focus. So small and cheap, yet so useful. Still, no autofocus, so you'll have to adjust the focus to your application. Now, on this camera module, there is an integrated RP2040 chip, just like on the original Raspberry Pi Pico. It's there for neural network firmware management, and it's not doing the bulk of the heavy neural network lifting. That falls to the Sony IMX500 Intelligent Vision Sensor, which has a neural network accelerator built in that tiny little package. The camera is 12.3 megapixels, and it can manage 10 frames a second at full resolution, which is over 4K. Or 30 frames per second at a quarter of that. Still, even a quarter of that is a lot more pixels than you can get on 1920 by 1080 full HD. So for most applications, I think the 2028 by 1520 is more than adequate and you'll get the smooth frame rate in return. The pixels are just 1.55 micrometers per side. It's also a pretty wide angle lens, able to see almost 80 degrees from left to right. The module has the same mounting hole spacing as the older ones, but it's a little bigger to accommodate the new hardware, so unless you're mounting it flat, your mounting accessories may not be 100% compatible. It works with all Raspberry Pi models, so anything from this old classic through the Raspberry Pi 4 to the 5. Now, there's a bit of an asterisk there. All Raspberry Pis? Not quite. Let's not forget that the Raspberry Pi Pico and Pico 2 are different animals completely and you can't just plug this camera into one of them. So, let's plug it in and see if we can get it going. Plug the camera into the Raspberry Pi, making sure that the black tip of the ribbon cable faces away from the Ethernet port. And on the camera side, a black tip should face backward. You'll see the installation instructions on the Raspberry Pi website, link in description, which tell you all the software and dependencies to install, and then you can start playing with object detection and pose estimation. I'm working on a review of the Raspberry Pi AI camera for an upcoming edition of Elektor magazine, and I'll be back soon to tell you about my experiments and give you some tips on the process. Until then, like and subscribe so you can be sure to keep up with our upcoming videos.